Hey guys, welcome back to the Moran family. So today's video is going to be what's in my hospital bag for baby number four. So since this is my fourth baby, I have a pretty good idea of what's a must have for me, what's not, what's pointless in bringing. So this is going to be a minimal hospital bag. This is my bag right here. This is actually the only bag I'm going to be bringing. I'm not bringing a diaper bag or anything else. So here is what my bag looks like. It's just a basic carry-on bag. As always, I will have everything linked down below. I will also go ahead and post my full hospital list right here on the screen if you guys want to go ahead and screenshot it and save it. That way you guys can have an idea of what to pack in your hospital bag. But with all that being said, let's go ahead and jump into this video. So the first things I'm going to go ahead and show you guys is stuff for myself, and then I will show you stuff that I packed for baby girl. So the first thing that I have for myself is some PJs. So I just have some PJ bottoms. These are super soft. So those are my bottoms. And then the top for these is just a oversized t-shirt. I'm actually not going to wear this PJ set when I'm in the hospital, like when I sleep in the hospital. I'm not going to be wearing this PJ set. I actually have another PJ that I am going to wear overnight, and I will explain to you guys why I'm wearing that one versus this one. But this one is actually going to be my going home outfit. I wanted to be as comfy as possible. With my first daughter, I actually wore leggings, and I tried to make myself presentable when going home, which honestly makes no sense because once I get home with the baby, I kind of just like lounge on the couch, I take a nap, I sleep, all of that stuff. So it's kind of pointless in like getting an actual outfit, in my opinion. So I just want to be as comfortable as possible. Also, my hospital is pretty far away, so it's going to be a drive getting back home. So I just wanted to be as comfy as possible. So I am going to be coming home in PJs. So the other PJ that I'm bringing, that I'm actually going to be wearing in the hospital, is just a basic t-shirt dress. So here's what this one looks like. It just says Sunday Bunday. I actually wore this one when I was in the hospital with Everly, and it's just so comfortable because it's just a basic t-shirt dress. So the reason why I like to wear a t-shirt dress instead of having something with bottoms is because if you've ever had a baby, then you know they are constantly checking you down there. They have to monitor your bleeding after you deliver, so you're constantly being checked down there. So just having a t-shirt dress on is so much easier versus having like pants or shorts, because then you'd have to pull them down in order for them to check your bleeding. So that is why I packed a t-shirt dress, because it's just easier for them to check you. So that is what I plan on wearing when I'm actually like in the hospital after I have given birth. Next, I am bringing two pairs of socks. I actually got these socks when I was in the hospital with one of the girls. I don't really remember who it was, but these were just an extra pair that I was given. So these are completely clean. I wasn't wearing these in the hospital at all. So these are just like the hospital socks with grips all over it. And then this pair is like more of an ankle sock, and these also have grips on the bottom. I'm not bringing slippers this time around, so if I do plan on walking around in the hospital, then I'm just probably going to walk around in these ones because they have grips. I believe most hospitals, you have to have socks on with grips, or you have to wear slippers when you're walking around because they don't want you slipping and falling. So that is why I have grip socks. Next things that I have packed for myself are some nursing bras. I am bringing two, and that is it. I honestly probably won't even use this one, because the way I usually do it is whenever I know I am going into labor and I know I'm going to head into the hospital, I change into something comfy and I change into my nursing bra. That way, whenever it's time to go home from the hospital, I can just throw on the outfit that I walked into the hospital. It just makes sense to do that for me, because when you walk into the hospital, you have to change into your gown anyway, so you're wearing the outfit that you're going into the hospital literally just for like the drive to the hospital. How many times can I say hospital in this video? But anyways, that's the way I like to do it. So my plan is to already be wearing a nursing bra. I've been wearing my nursing bras already because my other bras currently do not fit. So I'm actually wearing a bra from the set because these did come in a pack of three. So like I said, most likely I probably won't even use this one because I will probably already be wearing one when I walk in to be admitted. But just to be on the safe side, I figured might as well just throw one in my bag. So here is what the nursing bra looks like. This came in a pack of three, so it came with this nude one. And then the one that I'm wearing is kind of like a white, light pink color. And then it also comes with a black one. I highly recommend these. These are so soft, so comfortable. And I really like the band on these because they're a lot wider. This pack also came with like a bra extender, which is really nice when you're pregnant because you tend to like grow everywhere. So having that extender is really nice. And then these pack of bras also came with a little like hook thing. That way you can like crisscross these if you wanted to wear it like that. So that is the nursing bra that I am bringing. The other bra that I'm bringing is this one right here. This is a sleeping nursing bra. So there's literally like no clasp on here. It's kind of like a sports bra. This is really like comfortable. There's no padding or anything. You literally just like pull it down and nurse like that. So that's the other one that I'm bringing. I am bringing one pair of nursing pads. These are washable and I believe these are like bamboo, so they're extremely soft. Like I said, I will have everything linked down below. I probably won't use these because typically your milk doesn't come in until like around 3 days after you've had your baby. So I've never really leaked in the hospital, but I figured there's no harm throwing this in your bag just in case. Sometimes your body can be a little weird. The more children you have, your body, you know, starts doing things a lot earlier. So I figured I would throw these in my bag just in case I start to leak beforehand. So I just have one of those. Next thing that I'm bringing for myself, and these are 100% a must-have for me, shower flip-flops. It grosses me out so much being barefoot in a bathroom, like a public bathroom, and just like in the shower being barefoot in the hospital. I cannot do it. So shower flip-flops are 100% a must for me. Just the thought of showering in there barefoot just grosses me out so much because my mind just automatically goes to all of the other moms that were in there and you're like leaking and bleeding after you've had a baby. So I can't be in there barefoot. So shower flip-flops are 100% a must for me. These are just from Old Navy, so these were like a couple bucks, so completely inexpensive, but 100% a must. Next things that I have packed in my bag, and these are hands down my number one must-have. If I could only recommend one thing to pack in your hospital bag, it's adult diapers. So these are by the brand Always. These are their discreet boutique underwears, I believe is what they're called. So here is what they look like. I cannot recommend these enough. I wore these after I had Everly, and these were a game changer. I will never go back to wearing the mesh underwear that the hospital provides you. So if you haven't had a baby, the hospital does provide you something if you don't want to wear these. But I cannot recommend these enough. So they're not super thick to the point where they're going to be uncomfortable. You're not going to like hear the scrunching noise when you're walking around. You ladies know what I'm talking about whenever you have to wear like a giant pad. You also can't really tell underneath your clothes. I wore these when I had to like go out and about outside of the house. I was still wearing these a couple weeks postpartum because these were just a game changer. They were so comfortable, especially at night. These were a lot better than wearing a pad because, as you guys know out there, sometimes when you're wearing a pad and you're like rolling over in bed, the pad can shift and all of that stuff, and then you have leakage. These were amazing for wearing them at night, even during the day. I wore these a couple weeks postpartum, like I said, because I was bleeding for a while after I had Everly. So I cannot recommend these enough. I'm telling you guys, buy these. The last things that I'm bringing for myself are these two pouches right here. So this first one is just my toiletries bag. As you can see, I kept it very minimal. I'm not bringing too much. So what I have in here is a scrunchie. I typically always have one on my wrist, but you can never go wrong with having too many scrunchies. So I am packing one in here. I also have some lotion. This is by the brand Jergens. Then I have some shampoo and conditioner in here because I like taking a shower in the hospital. I know not everybody likes to take a shower in the hospital. They just wait until they get home. But I personally love that first shower after you've delivered. It just feels so amazing, so refreshing. So I always took a shower after I delivered. So that is why I'm bringing these. I also have some water cleansing wipes. These are also good for taking off your makeup, but I'm actually not bringing any makeup. I know some moms like to, and previously I did bring like a concealer, a powder, some mascara, just to kind of refresh myself. But with Everly, I didn't bring like any makeup at all. I didn't even like touch up my face or anything. I just used water wipes to kind of like wipe my face, just kind of refresh myself. And I actually liked it. Like, I liked not wearing any makeup. I think when I went in to the hospital, all I did was I just had my eyebrows done and that was it. I liked having a bare face. That way, if I did get like all hot and sweaty, I can just use my wipes, like I said, and just kind of give myself a refresher. So I plan on like going makeup free for the hospital. Like I said, if anything, I will have my eyebrows done, but that is about it. So the other two things that I have in here is just a travel toothbrush. So I have two, one for me, one for my husband. He is going to pack his own bag, but he is so easy. So he literally always just does it whenever I am in labor and like we're about to go out the door. He literally just throws like some shorts, boxers, socks, a shirt, and that is literally it for him. But I already know him. He's going to forget his toothbrush. I already know he's not going to be thinking about that, so I figured I would pack one in my bag for him. So that other pouch that I was showing you guys is actually my little snack bag. Previously, for my other kids, I never packed any snacks. Typically, I go into labor in the middle of the night, and then my labor runs like around like 24 hours. So then by the time I deliver, it's like the middle of the night again, which means the hospital cafeteria is closed, and I am always so hungry after I deliver. So I figured I would pack some snacks, especially since due to COVID, I believe you, once you're like admitted into the hospital, even having like your support person there, which for me would be my husband, you can't leave the hospital once you are admitted. So even my husband can't like go out and go grab a pizza like he normally would for us. So I figured having some snacks would be really good since he's not going to be able to go grab us some outside food. And just in case the hospital cafeteria is closed, I don't have too many in here. All I have is two Belveeta breakfast bars. These are kind of like cookies. These are the cinnamon brown sugar flavors. I love these. Benny isn't really too crazy for these, but I love them, so I'm bringing them. I also have two chocolate chip granola bars in here, just kind of for like a sweet craving. And then I randomly have like a pack of fruit snacks in here. That's literally all I have in here. So if you guys have any snack recommendations for the hospital, let me know, because like I said, I've never packed snacks previously, but I hear it's really good to have this time around with all of the COVID restrictions. So let me know if you guys brought snacks in your hospital bag. What did you bring? So that is everything that I'm bringing for myself in my hospital bag. So now let's jump into the fun stuff, baby girl stuff. I am not bringing a ton of stuff. Like I said, I tried to keep it as minimal as possible. So I only have like a handful of things for baby girl. So the first things I'm going to show you guys are her outfits. I'm only bringing two. I have a newborn size and then I have a 0 to 3 month size. That is it. I'm not bringing like mittens and all of the extra things like socks, and I'm not bringing like a big blanket or anything. I am keeping it super simple. So I plan on having her come home in this one. You guys know my due date is October 30th, so it is going to be pretty cool outside. It drops down pretty cold out here where we live, so I figured this one would be perfect for her to come in. It's not like super thick, it's also not really thin, so I figured this one would be perfect for her. So this one has the little feetsies on the bottom, and then it also has the fold over mittens. So that is probably going to be her coming home outfit. If for some reason she turns out to be a bigger baby than all of my other girls, I have this one as backup. This is 0 to 3 months, so this one is a little bit bigger just in case baby girl is big. I feel like you should always plan one small outfit and then one bigger outfit just in case you end up having a big baby for some reason. So here is the backup outfit. So this one has the feet as well. This one is not a zip up one though. This one is buttoned. And then this one also has the fold over mittens as well. So this is my backup outfit for her. And then I just have a few things in here for her. So I do have a beanie for her. This is a newborn beanie. I figured this one would keep her warm, and I figured it would look so cute with her little jammies. So that is her coming home outfit. The other thing that I'm bringing for baby girl is a swaddle. I thought this color was so pretty, especially since she's going to be born around Halloween time. So I figured this pumpkin red orange color would be so fitting for that. So I do plan on swaddling her up in this and then putting her little beanie on, taking her first picture in this, and I'm just so excited. Like, just thinking about wrapping her in this and seeing her in the little rainbow beanie brings me so much excitement, and I cannot wait. So this is the only swaddle that I'm going to be bringing for her, because the hospital has blankets and stuff, so I'm gonna just keep her wrapped up in the hospital's swaddle blankets. And then whenever I want to take her first picture and I want to bring her home, she's going to be swaddled up in this one. So I feel like one is all you need, because like I said, the hospital has a bunch that you can use there. So the last thing that I'm bringing for baby girl is a pacifier clip and a passy. This is actually the first time I'm bringing a pacifier to the hospital. I personally don't like to give my children a pacifier like straight out of the womb. I like to wait a little bit until we have breastfeeding down. So I am probably not going to like physically give this to baby girl. This is more of like just for her first photo, so this is more of just like a prop. So that's why I'm bringing this. I might switch out this pacifier because I kind of have like a certain theme going on with her first picture, if you guys can kind of get the vibe that I'm going for. So I have another pacifier in mind. I currently have it on my baby registry. I think it's by the brand Bibs. There's like this really pretty mauve pacifier that I want to get. So I'm hoping I get it for my baby shower, but if not, then I'm going to immediately purchase it after our shower, and then I'm probably going to throw that one in my hospital bag versus this one. But just in case baby girl decides to show up early, because you guys know I've been having contractions, I'm on bed rest, just in case she decides to come early, I want to have everything prepared, and I don't want to have to like think about things. So that's what I have for her for right now. So that is actually everything in my hospital bag. I do have some last minute things that need to go in my bag once I am in labor. So I have my list right here, so I'm just gonna read it to you guys. So the first thing that I have on my last minute checklist is my water bottle. I have a pretty decent sized insulated water bottle that keeps my water cold for like 24 hours. So I plan on bringing that because I get really thirsty after I deliver. I feel like I'm always chugging water. So I definitely want to bring my water bottle. I also have to remember to pack my glasses because your girl is blind. So I'm definitely going to be bringing my glasses. I also have to remember to pack a long phone charger. That is another must for me because whenever I have some downtime in the hospital, especially after I've gotten my epidural and things are a little bit calmer, I'm usually on my phone like updating family or like updating Instagram, all of that stuff. So having a long phone charger is definitely a must because your bed is kind of away from the wall, so the outlets are kind of far from you. So having the long phone charger is nice, that way you can still be on your phone when you're in the bed. So definitely recommend bringing that. I also have to pack my camera, my charger, my tripod, all of my YouTube stuff, that way I can film a baby girl's birth vlog for you guys. I also have to throw in a brush and some deodorant because I completely forgot to order that when I was ordering my little travel size shampoo and conditioner. So I have to either order that online or just throw my brush and deodorant that I have now in my bathroom in my bag whenever I do go into labor. But I definitely don't want to forget those two, so I just have it on my last minute list right now. So the very last thing that needs to go in my hospital bag, and I probably should have it by now because I'm already 33 weeks pregnant, but I keep procrastinating on it because I just haven't found like the perfect one that I want. It's a birth name sign. We haven't announced baby girl's name yet, and I do plan on announcing her name in our birth vlog. So I need like a little name sign, but I just can't find one that I'm loving. So I've been on the hunt for weeks. Hopefully I find one really soon because like I said, I've been having contractions. I'm 33 weeks pregnant. I feel like baby girl is going to be here really soon. So I really need to get on that. But that is the last thing that's gonna go in my bag, is baby girl's name announcement. But that is basically it, you guys. That is everything that I'm bringing in my hospital bag. I don't need any more, I don't need any less. I feel like this is the perfect amount of what you really need in your hospital bag. If you're a first-time mom, or even like second-time mom, third-time mom, fourth-time mom like myself, I hope this video was helpful for you. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. Make sure you guys are subscribed to the Moran family, and make sure you hit that bell. That way you guys always get notified every single time we upload. That way you don't miss our baby shower vlog, our birth vlog, all that fun stuff coming up. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys. Never up, never down, never. Like a theme in a song, clever.